In this video, we'll look at writing rational numbers in different formats. And the idea of rational numbers is really just fractions, the ratio of one number to another. So first, 1/2, well, we know that that equals the same as 0.5. Now let's look at something that may not be as familiar, and that's 7/8, the ratio of 7 to 8. Well, a fraction or a ratio can also be described as division. That's 7 divided by 8. And 8 then is going into 7 how many times? And it's 7.0 if you don't see anything else. So we have 8 going into 7, well, 8 goes into 7 0 times, and then 8 goes into 70. Well, how many times? Well, it goes in 8 times with 6 left over. With 6 left over. And then 8 goes into 60. How many times? Well, 8 goes into 60 7 times. That's 8 times 7 is 56. So you have 4 left over. How many times does 8 go into 40? Well, it goes in 5 times. So we end that, and then we can say that 7/8 equals 0.875. What if we do the same trick with 1/3? Well, with 1/3, that's 1 divided by 3. Well, in that case, 3 going into 1.0. We get something peculiar actually, and that is we get 0.333 and so on. It repeats. It's a repeating decimal. So 1/3 equals 0.3 repeating. Just the 3 is repeating. And that's what we say when we have a repeating decimal. It's just the digits that are being repeated. I have the line over them, and we'll see an example of 0.72, both 7 and 2 repeating in this next example. But before we go on, I want to show you that 2/3, if you see something 2/3, then that equals 0.6 repeating, and it does equal that. Now, oftentimes it's approximated as 0.67, and that's because if you have 0.66666 and so on, whenever you round, you're going to have to use the rule of rounding and round the next previous digit up. So we've approximated to 0.67 or 0.667, whatever it is, that last decimal will be rounded up. Now, on to the next one, and that is 0.72 repeating. So that equals 0.727272, and so on. Now, a little trick of converting that repeating decimal into a rational number is this. If we say that x equals 0.72 repeating, then we can say that 100 times, and we're going to multiply this by, we're going to have the number of zeros in here, the 100 or 1,000 or just 10, equal to the number of repeating decimal places. So we have 2, so it's 100. 100x then equals 72.72 repeating. Now if you subtract those, 100x minus x, what you get is 99x equals 72.72 repeating minus just 0.72. You're left with just the 72. So solving that equation, that is dividing by 99, you get x, which is what this equals. X equals 72 divided by 99. So x equals 72 divided by 99. Well, now if you simplify that, then you get this x, or 0.72 repeating, equaling 8 over 11. All right. So that's a nice little trick to convert repeating decimals back into a ratio or back into a fraction. Now, by the way, it doesn't have to be shown as a fraction to be called a rational number. So 0.5 is a rational number because you know that you can express it as a rational number or as a fraction. And 0.72 repeating is a rational number because you know you can express it as a ratio of two numbers. Next, 4 over 5. Now we know, or if you don't, you can quickly get to that that equals 0.8. Now another way to write 0.8 is 80%. So it's just another way to write rational numbers is in the format of percents, and that is take the decimal form and move the decimal point to the right two places. Now what if we have 15 over 8, an improper fraction? It's still a rational number. It's a ratio of 15 to 8. And you could play the same trick that we did over here of dividing, and I'll cut to the chase on this one and tell you that this equals 1.875. Now what if we wanted to do this and convert it into a percent? Well, that would be moving that decimal point to the right two places, and that is 187.5%. So 15 over 8 is more than 100%, so it makes sense that this is over 100%, 187.5%. Now, as long as we're talking about percents, let's add one more thing. You have a rational number within a percent, 0.5%. Now, don't be tripped up on this. Let's convert this fraction, 0.5, into a decimal like we did up here. So 0.5% equals 0.5%, which then equals, let's convert backwards into a decimal, equals 0.005 as a decimal. We just took the decimal point and moved it two places to the left and then removed the percent. And this rational number of 0.005 then equals, I'll change colors just to clarify here, equals 5/1000ths, 5/1000. And that, then you, of course, you could simplify that, and that equals 1/200. So quite a bit different from just 0.5. 0.5% is the ratio of 1 to 200.